Welcome to the Common Man Football Show. My name is James Coburn, and today's episode, we're talking about the 2018 NFL Draft Class, and specifically production analytics relating to Georgia running back Sonny Michel. Sonny Michel has been one of those types of prospects that has gotten a huge bump over a while. You know, when you think about Georgia's backfield, a lot of people were on the Nick Chubb bandwagon. And don't get me wrong, Nick Chubb is a fabulous running back in his own right. But Sonny Michel has been that guy that has flipped the script. You know, where a lot of people were saying you had Nick Chubb and then you had Sonny Michel, who was kind of a background guy. And this season in particular, he elevated himself to even more than just a background guy. So I think Sonny Michel is a guy that is interesting as a prospect, and his data is interesting as well, which is what this video is going to center around. Now, if you're new to the channel and you're new to the work that I do analytics, and specifically stuff like market share data, stuff like explosive lower body strength score, speed score, flexibility score, stuff that you're probably not familiar with. So all terms and definitions are going to be in the description in terms of the pertinent information, so that if there's anything that you don't really understand that I'm talking about that I don't really explain well enough to you, you can just go to the description and all that information will be there for you to give you a little bit of taste of that information. So for the most part, this video is going to center just around production data. I am going to be doing some videos in the future, and I think Sonny Michel will probably be included in that video, exploring other things such as age, athleticism, and just a total analytical view of him. But this video, again, is primarily production data. Now, the only sort of thing you need to know in terms of production data is what market share data is. And when it comes to the running back position, market share data is essentially total offensive market share data, which is rushing plus receiving yards of a running back divided by the team total yardage. And it's best single season as well. So the season that a running back has the best, like the most receiving plus rushing yards divided by the team total, that's essentially what you do. And essentially what total offensive market share is say a running back has 1,000 yards of total offensive yardage, receiving plus rushing, on a team that had 4,000 yards of total offense. Based on that math, you know, you divide 1,000 by 4,000, you get 25%. What you do with that number is you take that number and you compare it to every single running back performance since the 1969 NFL draft class. Then boom, you have a way of seeing where the majority of the special backs typically performed when it comes to data, and the averages therein of long-term starters, Pro Bowlers, All-Pro players, and all those other types of players. So essentially, it's just a way of gauging what the potential of a running back is based on what every other running back did over a time span of many decades. So that's essentially what this is. So getting into Sonny Michel's data, he had a 69.32 out of 100 market share production score. Based on my data, again, since 1969, he didn't really hit the All-Pro threshold, the multiple All-Pro threshold of 89 or higher, and that threshold is where the special running backs are. That's like that's guys like Barry Sanders, Emmitt Smith, Ezekiel Elliott was one of those guys that was in that area. That's just like the ultra-rare sort of area of running backs, and Sonny Michel didn't quite produce like that, but he at least hit the five-time Pro Bowl threshold, where that is basically the bottom end threshold for five-time Pro Bowlers, and that's still a very good place to be. You know, that's basically the second tier of high-quality outcomes. Also hit the three-time Pro Bowl area of 52 or higher. So when it comes to Sonny Michel, he has above-average production, so there's really nothing to be too concerned about in terms of his overall data. Then, of course, when you look at the averages at the position, so the average All-Pro score, again, Sonny Michel doesn't quite look like a multiple All-Pro type running back, but he does hit at least closer to the averages of a Pro Bowl player and the averages of a long-term starter for the most part. So Sonny Michel essentially, based on his market share data, based on his production profile, looks like a Pro Bowler to starter caliber player, which is pretty good. It's pretty good to be in that sort of area. So again, once the combine comes around, we'll have more information about athleticism and those other sort of things. But for right now, Sonny Michel looks pretty good. If you think Sonny Michel is a potential above average running back at the NFL level, so far, based on production metrics, he looks to be a guy that could do that. So that's pretty much the down low in terms of Sonny Michel's production data. And of course, my name is James Coburn. You can find my other work at draftcoburn.wordpress.com. You can also follow me on Twitter at Jimmetrics. And if you like this content and you want more content like this, be sure to leave a like and subscribe. Share this video as well with anybody that you know. Hit that notification button so that you're always reminded when another video of mine drops. And also be sure to check out my 2018 NFL Free Agency offense guide. In that guide, it is $9.99 on Amazon, and it's available on Kindle. And in that guide, it has profiles on pretty much all the quarterbacks that are hitting free agency this year, all the running backs that are hitting free agency or at least set to hit free agency, wide receivers, tight ends, and offensive linemen. The majority of those guys is in that guide. It's a ton of information, and it will make you more informed as anything, as a fan, etc. So be sure to buy that. All the money from that helps to fund this channel. It helps to fund, you know, everything, really, in terms of me keep doing what I'm doing, in terms of data work and this other sort of stuff. So be sure to check out that guide and buy that guide if you don't have a chance. Again, I highly recommend you get that if you're interested in free agency and want to know a little bit more about just anything, really, in terms of the prospects that are available in free agency in the NFL. And again, with that out of the way, I will talk to you guys in the next video. Peace.